Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss how to find joint, marginal and conditional relative frequencies from a two-way table and find whether there is an association between the two categories or not. Now, in level 1, we have discussed the method of constructing and reading a two-way table, and we had also learned to find relative frequency. Now let us recall, a two-way table organizes data that can be categorized in two variables. For example, if we have two categories like male-female, red, blue, agree, disagree, etc., then we make a two-way frequency table. Now suppose we have a table. Now here we have two categories. One category is male, female, and other category is agree, disagree. We arrange them in rows and columns. One category is written in columns and other in rows. We use this table to find whether male females agree or disagree, or males agree or disagree, and things like that. Now here from the table we can read that 3 males agree and 8 females agree. We can also find total of rows and columns. Now 8 plus 3 is 11. This is row total, and 3 plus 7 is 10, which is column total. And total of 2 columns and 2 rows is same, that is 20. And sum of all values, that is 3 plus 8 plus 7 plus 2, is equal to 20. And now we will study joint and marginal frequencies. Then joint relative frequency, then marginal relative frequency, and conditional relative frequency. First of all, let us discuss joint and marginal frequencies. Now, each frequency that occurs where a row category meets a column category is referred to as joint frequency. Now in this table there are 4 joint frequencies, 3, 8, 7 and 2. Now here you can see when agree meets male, we have value 3. So it is joint frequency. Since the row and column total are given in margins, they are called marginal frequencies. The marginal frequencies represent the frequencies of two categories for the corresponding variable. Now here you can see total of rows is 11 and 9 respectively, and total of columns is 10 and 10 respectively. So these are marginal frequencies. And now let us discuss joint relative frequencies. Now joint relative frequencies are the values in which each category is divided by the sum of all the values. Now in this table we have total of 20. We divide each cell value by 20, that is 3 by 20, which is equal to 0.15, then 8 by 20, which is equal to 0.4, 7 by 20, which is equal to 0.35, and 2 by 20, which is equal to 0.1. Now these are joint relative frequencies, and these are called joint because each cell is related with both categories, like 3 is related to number of males that agree. This table shows how the two categories or variables behave together. So, this is the joint relative frequency table, or we can say joint relative frequency two-way table. And now let us discuss marginal relative frequencies. Since joint frequencies show how the two categories or variables behave together, we may also be interested to know how each category or variable behave separately. And we can obtain this information by finding marginal frequencies for the two variables or categories. Now the marginal relative frequencies are found by adding the joint relative frequencies in each row and column. Now the marginal relative frequency for male is obtained by adding the joint relative frequencies of that column, that is 0.15 plus 0.35, which is equal to 0.5. So we have marginal relative frequency for male is 0.5. Similarly, marginal relative frequency for female is 0.4 plus 0.1, which is equal to 0.5. Also, marginal relative frequency for agri is obtained by joint relative frequencies of that row, that is 0.15 plus 0.4, which is equal to 0.55. Then marginal relative frequency for disagree is 0.35 plus 0.1, which is equal to 0.45. Now 0.5 plus 0.5 is 1, and here also 0.55 plus 0.45 is again 1. Now in this table, yellow shaded cells show joint relative frequencies and blue shaded cells show marginal relative frequencies. For each category, and now let us discuss conditional relative frequency. Now when we want to compare or find association between the categories or variables, we use conditional relative frequency. It is used when we have to find something about one category with a condition of other category. And for finding conditional relative frequency, we divide joint relative frequency by marginal relative frequency. And marginal relative frequency is chosen according to the condition that is given. For example, we want to find that from the people that agree, what proportion is of males and females. So, the given condition is that they agree. So, we will take marginal relative frequency corresponding to category agree. Now, marginal relative frequency for agree is 0.55. Now, joint relative frequency of agreed males is 0.15. So, conditional relative frequency will be equal to joint relative frequency of agreed males, that is 0.15, upon marginal relative frequency for agree, that is 0.55, and this is equal to 0.27 approximately. So, proportion of males that agree is 0.27 approximately. And now let us find proportion of females that agree. Now joint relative frequency of agreed females is 0.4. So proportion of females that agree is equal to 0.4 upon 0.55, which is equal to 0.73 approximately. Now from this proportion we can see that females agree more than males. Also you may note that we can convert this in percentage by multiplying each conditional relative frequency by 100. So 0.27 will be equal to 0.27 into 100, which is equal to 27%. And 0.73 into 100 will be equal to 73%. So, we see that among the people who agree, 27% are males and 73% are females. Now, we can also find the conditional relative frequency from this original table. Now from this original table you can see that number of males who agree is 3, that is joint frequency, and total number of people who agree is 11, that is marginal frequency. So conditional relative frequency is equal to 3 upon 11, which is equal to 0.27 approximately. So here we are getting the same answer. So in this session we have discussed how to find joint, marginal and conditional relative frequencies from a two-row table. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.